Kingdom Kids. We're so excited that you're with us this morning. You're just in time for our celebration.
Wait for me, wait for me. I've got the balloons and I love a celebration. I love cake too. What are we celebrating today?
Well, Miss Susan, you made it just in time. We were just about to tell the Kingdom Kids all about our celebration today and your red balloons will fit right in.
Awesome, I'm gonna go listen.
Woo!
Did you know?
Do you know that today is a special day for Christians? It has to do with the color red and a birthday. Can you guess what it is? It's Pentecost Sunday.
So now that we know it's Pentecost Sunday, does anybody remember what Pentecost is? It's not just a big word.
It's a very special time in the Bible when the disciples and other believers in Jesus received the Holy Spirit. It is celebrated on the Sunday 50 days after Easter. It is also known as the birthday of the Christian church.
So let's think back to our lesson that we learned last week. Remember, we talked about the Holy Spirit and that it's the third part of our Holy Trinity. We have the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We talked last week about how the Holy Spirit lives in our hearts and lets us know that God loves us and wants us to be like Him. It's our helper and our guide.
Well, just before Jesus was taken back to heaven, He made the disciples a promise. He said they would receive the Holy Spirit and it would give them the power to tell others about Him.
We learn in Acts chapter 2, verse 1, that after Jesus went back to heaven, all the disciples and other friends of Jesus would come together in a room and have meals together, pray together, and talk about all the things that Jesus had taught them.
Well, something really exciting happened next. Let's see if Miss Amy can tell us all about it.
It was during one of these times together that another strange and wonderful event happened. Suddenly, from out of nowhere came the sound of a rushing, mighty wind. It sounded like a huge tornado was right in the room with them. And that wasn't all. Flames of fire rested just above each person's head. No one got burned. They were given the gift of the Holy Spirit, which gave them the power to speak in languages that they had never even spoken before. There were a lot of extra people in Jerusalem from different countries that spoke different languages during this time because they were having a celebration for the harvest season. But guess what? Because of the power of the Holy Spirit, they were all able to hear about Jesus in their own languages. That's amazing. Isn't that wonderful? A lot of people were excited to be hearing how wonderful God was and the things He did. But some people didn't understand and thought the people were a little crazy. So Peter explained to the people that they were not crazy. They were just excited because they had just received the Holy Spirit into their hearts. Peter told them all about the teaching of Jesus and that He was the Son of God and that they should accept Him. He also told them that they should ask for forgiveness for their sins and to be baptized, so that they could receive the Holy Spirit also. On that day, over 3,000 people became believers and were baptized. That's a lot of people. This was the beginning of the Christian church.
Now it's time for
Did You Know?
Did you know that there are over 7,000 different languages in the whole world? And in the United States, we have over 350 different languages.
Bet you can't guess what language is spoken the most in the world. Mandarin, Chinese, and it's the most difficult to learn.
Another neat one is that NASA astronauts have to learn Russian. And did you know the official language in the sky? It's English. Yes, all pilots have to use English to identify themselves in the air.
We just learned that at Pentecost there were people from different countries. So of course some spoke different languages. Well, you would think since we all live in the United States, our English words would mean all the same thing, right? I mean, it's English.
Have you ever heard of the word bubbler? Well, that's what people in Boston call a water fountain.
And in the South, the phrase, give me some sugar, doesn't mean I need to borrow a cup of sugar. It means give me a kiss.
Also, we Southerners usually say y'all, which really means you all.
And the funniest one that I've heard is that the people in the state of Vermont call people that come to see the fall leaves, leaf peepers.
People live living on the West Coast, which can be California, they say gnarly. So when something's really good, like that movie was so good, they say that movie was gnarly.
Another weird one is that there are three different words for a soft drink in our own country. Some people call it soda, some people call it pop, and some people call it Coke, whether it's really a Coke or not.
Oh my goodness, Miss Caitlin and Miss Jill, it can be so silly how different people talk in different states. Now, let's hear a song from Miss Melinda.
Hey Kingdom Kids, it's Miss Melinda and I've got a new friend today. This is Dale Forsman. This is Lila and Violet's cousin and he's gonna help us with our song. It's Pentecost Sunday and we're going to sing when the Spirit says sing. And we're gonna sing, aren't we, Dale? And then we're going to clap, we're gonna jump, and we're gonna dance, right? Okay, so here we go. You ready? Watch the camera. I'm gonna sing when the Spirit says sing. I'm gonna sing when the Spirit says sing. When the Spirit says sing, I'm gonna sing right along. I'm gonna sing when the Spirit says sing. Ready to clap? I'm gonna clap when the Spirit says clap. I'm gonna clap when the Spirit says clap. When the Spirit says clap, I'm gonna clap right along. I'm gonna clap when the Spirit says clap. You're gonna jump? I'm gonna jump when the Spirit says jump. I'm gonna jump when the Spirit says jump. When the Spirit says jump, I'm gonna jump right along. I'm gonna jump when the Spirit says jump. Now we're gonna dance. I'm gonna dance when the Spirit says dance. I'm gonna dance when the Spirit says dance. When the Spirit says dance, I'm gonna dance right along. I'm gonna dance when the Spirit says dance. Kingdom Kids, enjoy Pentecost Sunday, and I want you to sing
and to clap
and to dance and to jump. We'll see you next week. Bye-bye.
The birthday of the church.
Do you know what a person becomes part of when they love Jesus and become a Christian? They become part of the church. And being part of the church means being a part of a new family, the church family. On the first day of the festival, 3,000 people became Christians. But you know what? The church family grew even more the rest of the festival. It was an awesome celebration. But at the end of the festival, people were sad. They didn't want to leave their new church family and their new Christian friends. But guess what? That was God's plan all along. You see, before Jesus had gone back into heaven, he told the disciples, the church is going to start in Jerusalem, but it's going to spread throughout the earth. So when the people got home, the celebration had not ended. The celebration was just beginning, and they were telling everyone they knew about Jesus, and more people became Christians. You know, I love a beautiful church building. Our church building is fabulous. But the first church was not in a building. Right now, I am standing in an outdoor chapel. It was built by Boy Scouts as another place to meet and worship. If you look, you can see the cross. You can see a pulpit or a place to sing or teach or preach. And in front of me are these wooden benches where people can sit. This is a great place to come meet together and worship. And it reminds me of the first church and how they didn't have a grand building to meet in. They were meeting outside in courtyards or in fields or maybe even under a tree, but they were meeting. And the church since that time has grown from being in homes, and the more people that came, they did start building buildings so different people could meet in their buildings. And it's so much more fun to meet as a group. But Pentecost teaches us that the church is not a building. Over the past few weeks, we have learned that we can't worship together. We're worshiping in our homes, but we can still be the church because the church is the people and people doing the ministry of our Lord. And that's what we've been doing. I look forward to seeing you back in our church very, very soon. But until then, we can be the church because Jesus lives in our heart and we can take Jesus and the church wherever we go.
That's exactly right, Miss Susan. Are you guys ready for a craft? Take it away, Miss Caitlin.
Hey, Kingdom Kids, welcome back.
We will be making a really cool craft today. It is so simple, but it is so fun. We will be making a stained glass window that has a dove in it. Why a dove, Miss Caitlin? A dove is a symbol for the Holy Spirit. So the only things you're gonna need are a piece of paper, pencil, you might want some colorful markers, and a ruler. You also might want to do a quick Google search so you can ask mom and dad if they can help you for a dove outline just to know how to draw it, okay? So to get started, you are going to want your plain paper. First thing you're gonna do is draw your dove in the center of your paper. Again, you can look up an outline and just do the best you can. It doesn't have to be perfect. Once you do that, you are then going to use your ruler and a pencil and you're gonna start sectioning off all these different backgrounds, okay? So you can make any sort of shapes you want. This one has a triangle, this one has four sides. Any shape will do just fine. Once you do this, you're going to outline everything in a black marker, okay? Once you have everything outlined, then you're gonna start coloring in and make your stained glass window. So it's a super simple craft, but look how beautiful it looks when you're done. All right, Kingdom Kids, we'll see you next week.
Thanks, Miss Caitlin. On the exciting day of Pentecost, the disciples received the Holy Spirit. You and I, and all believers of Christ, receive the Holy Spirit too, when you love Jesus and ask Him into our hearts. Isn't that awesome?
Today we learned all about Pentecost and the birthday of the Christian Church. That's something to celebrate! And during this year, 2020, Philadelphia Presbyterian Church is also celebrating a milestone birthday. Drum roll, please. We are 250 years old. Yay! Founded in 1770, Philadelphia Presbyterian Church is one of the oldest churches in Mecklenburg County. We are proud and thrilled to be part of this thriving and vibrant church family, which is a part of the greater church family we celebrate today on Pentecost Sunday. Behind us is the historical room to Philadelphia Presbyterian Church, which holds lots of information about our first 250 years. And we look forward to spreading the word of Jesus for many years to come. Thank you for coming to our birthday party today, Kingdom Kids. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear church. Happy birthday to you. Have a great week, Kingdom Kids. Gotta go eat my cake. Bye.